The U.S. Air Force has revealed the first glimpse of the AGM-181A Long-Range Standoff LRSO missile. The missile is in development for several years. The LRSO is being designed to replace the aging AGM-86B air-launched cruise missile, ALCM, which is currently the only nuclear-armed cruise missile in the U.S. arsenal. The program is a critical priority for both the U.S. Air Force and Global Strike Command. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how AGM-181A Long-Range Standoff Missile LRSO is set to enhance American nuclear deterrence. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The AGM-86, which the LRSO is set to replace, was initially expected to serve only through the 1990s, after which it would be succeeded by the more advanced AGM-129 Advanced Cruise Missile, ACM. The AGM-129, featuring greater range, stealth, and overall capability, entered service in 1990. However, following the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, the perceived risk of nuclear conflict declined. By the mid-2000s, the U.S. opted to retire the costly AGM-129 fleet and reduce its inventory of nuclear cruise missiles to around 528 aging AGM-86. Although life extension programs, similar to those applied to the Minuteman III ICBM, have kept the AGM-86 operational, the system has reached the end of its technological and structural limits, prompting the need for a modern replacement. On July 1, 2021, the U.S. Air Force awarded Raytheon a cost-plus fixed-fee contract for the engineering and manufacturing development stage of the LRSO program, with options that could take the contract to about $2 billion. The service could buy more than 1,000 missiles. By December 2022, the missile had undergone at least 9 test flights. In March 2023, the missile passed a critical design review. The first unclassified rendering of the LRSO reveals several key design features, most notably an inverted tail configuration reminiscent of the stealthy, conventionally armed AGM-158 JASSM. A similar tail arrangement was seen on the AGM-129, though with a differently shaped vertical stabilizer. The missile also appears to have a trapezoidal fuselage cross-section and a wedge-shaped nose, with wing contours that closely resemble those of the JASSM. Interestingly, the rendering does not show any visible air inlet. This omission may be deliberate for security reasons, as air intake designs are often highly classified elements in stealth systems. Alternatively, the inlet could be positioned on the upper side of the missile, out of view. It's also important to note that official concept renderings like this are often sanitized for public release. Certain details may be omitted, altered, or intentionally misleading to protect sensitive aspects of the missile's true design. Details about the LRSO's full capabilities remain scarce, as much of the program is still highly classified. However, it is expected to be a subsonic missile with significantly greater range than its predecessors, built around a stealth-optimized airframe, an engine designed to be extremely difficult to detect and track. The range is expected to be similar or a bit more than AGM-86 and will be about 2,500 kilometers or about 1,550 miles. The missile will likely incorporate strict emissions control, advanced navigation systems capable of operating in GPS-denied environments, and resilience against dense electronic warfare. A key feature will likely include the ability to autonomously assess and respond to threats en route, optimizing its flight path to maximize survivability and mission success. These capabilities are designed to ensure the missile and its launch platform can operate effectively, even in heavily defended airspace, as long-range integrated air defense systems continue to evolve rapidly. The LRSO will be armed with the W80-4 nuclear warhead, which offers an adjustable yield, or dial-a-yield mid-option. This warhead can deliver a low-yield blast of approximately 5 kilotons, roughly one-third the power of the bomb dropped on Hiroshima, or a much higher yield of 150 kilotons, around 10 times the power of that same World War II weapon. This flexibility enhances the missile's strategic utility across a range of potential scenarios. It is likely that there will be no conventionally armed variant of the LRSO. This new weapon system, built by Raytheon, will be carried by both the new B-21 Raider and the vulnerable B-52 Stratofortress. The key carrier of the missile will be the B-21 Raider. Viewers may note that B-21 is significantly more stealthier compared to B-1 Spirit, since it has more optimized airframe, new radar-absorbing material, and improved exhaust control to reduce the heat signature. The stealthy bomber will be an ideal match for LRSO. The B-52, being a non-stealthy bomber, will benefit from the long range of LRSO since it could be launched from standoff distances. B-52H variant is able to launch 20 AGM-86B missile. A similar quantity of LRSO will probably be carried by the bomber. Regarding the cost, a 2023 report cited the Pentagon's acquisition estimates from December 2022. Which projected the total acquisition cost of the LRSO program based on a planned purchase of 1,020 missiles at just over $16 billion. An additional $7 billion was anticipated for sustaining the missiles over a 30-year service life. More recent estimates suggest the unit cost of each LRSO is now approximately $14 million. To give viewers a perspective, a Tomahawk costs around $2 million, while AGM-158 JASSM, about $1 million. A country's nuclear deterrence relies on its ability to maintain a nuclear triad. The capability to launch nuclear weapons from land-based missiles, strategic bombers in the air, and submarines at sea. The U.S. nuclear triad includes bombers like B-52 and strike aircraft with nuclear bombs and missiles. Ohio-class submarines armed with Trident 2D5 missiles and Minuteman 3 ICBMs. Each leg has its own pros and cons. While bombers and fighters offer greater flexibility as they can be positioned anywhere around the globe, and a strike can be withdrawn even at the last moment, they are more susceptible to interception. LRSO's large strike envelope will significantly reduce this risk. In 2021, Patty Jane Geller, former senior policy analyst, Center for National Defense, providing her insights, had stated LRSO allows the U.S. president to deter an adversary from attacking first and respond proportionately to an adversary's limited use of nuclear weapons. That flexibility, she said, makes air defense more complicated for U.S. adversaries, forcing them to plan for incoming cruise missiles from multiple attack vectors. If this initial rendering is any indication, the LRSO program has made significant progress in its development. It's likely that more details will emerge soon, and a full public unveiling may not be far off. The missile is currently slated to enter operational service toward the end of the decade.